Okay, I realized I had never done a demo video for our iPad app. I think because the recording software I use did not support iPad app, but now it does apparently, so cool. I will warn that I think the recording software might change some of the text, so it might appear a little bit lighter or different than it normally is. So ignore that in the video, go download the app and you'll see the normal text. If it appears light in the screen recording, sorry about that. It's just because I'm using a recording software. But pretty cool that I can record the demo on the iPad app here. So I wanted to pull it up here to show a couple things. So first of all, if you are using it for the first time, you will first need to download Reflect through Test Flight. Very easy. Just go to reflect.app/download and you'll see a button for iPad, which will take you to this screen. And you just download the Test Flight app and then download the Reflect app. Now, the reason for that is just because it's still technically in developer mode, which means we can push updates to it without having Apple approve them. So it allows us to make these updates just a lot faster. So once that's downloaded, you just open it like normal and you get pretty much the full desktop experience, but here on the iPad. So let me highlight a couple things. I should point out, I guess, first of all, that this is a blank graph, so no notes are going to show up in the searches. But, you know, for example, here I am in the advanced search. If I had all of my books in here, I could select the book tag, and then chat with my notes. And you can just kind of use this as a chatbot like normal. That is not available on the iPhone app, only on the desktop apps and the iPad here. Oh, there's also the new chat reset button here that's available. Okay, cool. Some other things here. So I guess the tasks manager is on the iPhone app, but I think there's more functionality in iPad. Like you've got the add buttons here. Oops. So you can add them directly from the page and whatnot. You've got the mind map, which again, this is going to be blank because I don't have any existing notes. So I probably won't wait for that to pull up. And then on the side here, you've got the meetings. So I'm not going to pull up the one with Miles because I don't want to share his contact info, but this is just kind of a general learning reminder I have on my calendar, to take any course that I'm currently going through. So, you know, you can have the meeting assistant, which you integrate through your calendars. So again, unlike the iPhone app, you know, you can go in here and through the connections page, you can add your calendars and also sync your contacts. So some of those settings and preferences you can do. Actually, while I'm here, you can go adjust kind of the API settings and anything else. AI settings, one of which is the API keys and anything else here on the iPad app. Again, same functionality. What else? You know, you've got like the calendar screen here. What else would not be on the desktop app? I honestly think that's pretty much it. Similar things like, you know, you have the AI assistant. So if you highlight text, you can access it with the magic stars there. That's also on the iPhone app, but thought I would just mention that you can also do it here. I'll exit out of that task there. So yeah, I think that's pretty much it. One of the only things that I don't think is on here, I don't actually know how to access the option key, but I'm not sure that you can access the inline transcriber, so I'll have to check on that one. That's the only question mark I have. Everything else you should be able to access. Oh, voice transcriber, that's also here. Again, also on the iPhone app, but you can transcribe it here on the iPad as well. So yeah, if you haven't tried it yet, go play around with it. It's in a pretty great state, and Voitech's also making lots of updates to it as well. This week, we just announced the SQLite update was brought to the iPad app, so it's now a lot faster, a lot more responsive. It's slowed down a little bit on the recording here just because the software is so in-depth, I think. But yeah, go check it out. Let us know what you think.